Disgraceful. Welcome to Unfiltered. I'm SE Cupp. That's the word Officer Michael Fanone used to describe the way Republican lawmakers have chosen to downplay and even lie about the violent insurrection at the U.S. Capitol on January 6th. The indifference shown to my colleagues, he said as he pounded his fist on the table, is disgraceful. He went on, nothing, truly nothing, has prepared me to address those elected members of our government who continued to deny the events of that day. It was an emotional moment in a hearing full of emotional moments, where four heroic law enforcement officers described in graphic and unvarnished detail the horrific attack on American democracy and indeed on them. Their testimony left it unambiguous as to what happened. A violent mob stormed the Capitol to undo an election, because former President Donald Trump encouraged them to. Just before that hearing began, Republican Congresswoman Elise Stefanik, the newly elected House GOP conference chair, would foreshadow Fanone's indictment of Republican lawmakers who continue to disgracefully betray our men in uniform. Holding a press conference to pre-butt the testimony, she said, inexplicably, "The American people deserve to know the truth. That Nancy Pelosi bears responsibility as Speaker of the House for the tragedy that occurred on Jan 6th. That's right, the Democratic Speaker, who herself was targeted that day by a violent mob, was to blame. Imagine being this craven, this cruel, this shameless." Stefanik wasn't done, though. In the hours after that testimony, facing backlash for her ghoulish attempt at distracting Americans from obvious reality, she tweeted, "The mainstream media serves as lame duck Nancy Pelosi's loyal stenographers. No questions allowed about Speaker Pelosi, all off limits. Speaker of the House clearly bears responsibility for not securing the U.S. Capitol on Jan 6th, but the drooling media is too petrified to ask." This would be funny if it weren't so sad. Funny because, you see, we are asking. Here at CNN and elsewhere, we are asking to know more about what happened that day. It's Republicans like Stefanik and Fox News hosts like Laura Ingraham who are not asking, who don't want to hold the very hearing in which Congress is asking what happened that day. If she and House Minority Leader Kevin McCarthy are so interested in exactly who is to blame for failing to secure the Capitol, why have they been so resistant to a hearing? Of course, this is a shameless and ridiculous attempt at obfuscation. As Republican Congressman Adam Kinzinger, one of only two Republicans on the Select Committee, put it perfectly, "We will investigate the security posture on January 6th. But blaming the security for the violence on that day is like blaming an assault victim because of what she was wearing." The Speaker of the House, of course, is not responsible for the security of Congress. The Capitol Police are. Stefanik knows this. She's not stupid. She is, however, disgraceful, to quote Officer Fanone. It's the only word that can describe her spectacular misuse of power and platform. And what a disappointment. Many, including some Democrats I know, were excited when Stefanik came to Congress in 2015. The youngest woman ever elected, she'd been an aide to George W. Bush and promised a fresh, modern face for the GOP. Marie Claire magazine featured her as one of the 50 most influential women in America that year, calling her smart, likable, social media savvy, and the GOP's secret weapon. This is not likely what they had in mind. Instead of using her newfound influence to bring the Republican Party into the 21st century, to attract new voters like women and minorities and millennials, to stand up for conservatism as Trump tried to corrupt it, to stand up for the truth as Trump tried to distort it, Stefanik got a little taste of power, and boy, did she like it. Now it seems power and staying in Trump's good graces is all that matters. As the old adage goes, power tends to corrupt, and absolute power corrupts absolutely. What a shame. What a disgrace. That's it for me. See you next week.